Hey y'all, here's the deal. It's St. Patrick's Day, and we don't have a lot of traditions that we do for different holidays throughout the year. A few for Christmas, a few for Thanksgiving. But oddly enough, St. Patrick's Day is the day that we just decided, all right, we love this holiday and we're going to do little things to celebrate. So we do, typically we, watch a movie set in Ireland with my sister Liz, but she's out of state right now. So Danielle and I are going to watch a different movie. It's not even set in Ireland. Explaining this out loud makes it really seem illegitimate, but it's special to us. So, but one thing that we do every holiday is make Irish beef chuck stew and Irish soda bread, and we just listen to Irish music all day long, and we just, in our own little way, we celebrate the culture and also celebrate St. Patrick in our own little way. His story is pretty incredible to me, even though there's a lot of gray area as far as what is true and what is not. I'm just excited. I just love it. I feel very at home when I'm listening to Irish music and when I'm eating this old peasant food. There's something very warming and significant about it in my life in particular, and I'm thankful for that. So we're gonna get started. I'm gonna bring you along. We just left church and it's 1:45. We are going to make this stew early so that we can just have it ready right at dinner time instead of like waiting till the last second and making it. And we'll make the bread a little later in the day. But the stew takes a while to make because you have to create the slurry and you have to cook down the meat and, you know, chop all these vegetables. It's got turnips, carrots, potatoes, onion, garlic, beef stock. And this particular recipe is supposed to have stout in it. I don't really like the thought of putting stout in my stew. I just feel like it's gonna add, I don't love the flavor of beer in the first place, so I feel like it's going to add a flavor that I won't appreciate. But let's just get started. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Let's enjoy this day together. St. Patrick was one of the first people to bring the gospel to Ireland. He grew up in Britain, and when he was 16, he was kidnapped by Irish slave traders, and he was sold to a farmer and tended sheep. For 6 years, I think it was, he was in slavery, and he escaped. Years later, though,
He said that he heard God in his dreams telling him to go back and to bring the gospel to the people of Ireland. And he did, and he served faithfully there for 40 years.
Okay, so we have our potatoes, turnips, and carrots chopped into this bowl. Two large yellow onions, and two cloves of garlic provided by my friend Emma. Thank you, Emma, for sponsoring this meal. 2.5 pounds of beef chuck roast. This is just what pulls the whole stew together. Good stuff. Gil likes it too. He's been eating the scraps. After I finish cutting. Beef broth. And Danielle made this really yummy carrot salad. I am.
I think I'm okay with it.
I don't want you to think that we enjoy this holiday because of what Patrick did. We enjoy it because it's a testimony and a reminder of what God does and can do in people's lives. Even just namely in St. Patrick's life. It started with him, and this is something he wrote in his confession, but it was here in Ireland that God first opened my heart, so that even though it was a late start, I became aware of my failings and began to turn with my whole heart to the Lord my God. For he looked down on my miserable condition and had compassion for me. Young and foolish as I was, he cared for me before I knew who he was. Before I could tell the difference between right and wrong, he protected me and loved me even as a father does his own child. God used the time to shape and mold me into something better. He made me into what I am now, someone very different from what I once was, someone who can care about others and work to help them.
I'm always taller than I think I am.
Zoe, just let that cook down for about 2 hours. 3:30, it'll be about 5:30, 6 by the time it's finished, and we'll have our soda bread and our jam, and we'll have a good time. Yeah. Where's the lid? I think it's down here.
My final prayer is that all of you who believe in God and respect Him, whoever you may be, who read this letter that Patrick, the unlearned sinner, wrote from Ireland, that none of you will ever say that I, in my ignorance, did anything for God. You must understand, because it is the truth, that it was all the gift of God. Thank you.
Catholic prayer over our
Please do.
Stop!
It was an awful sound. Okay, go ahead.